The light! I found it, Watson! Light dispels darkness! I must fire up the lighthouse! Hold fast, Watson! I must continue searching.
I make one movement forward and he starts talking again. Okay, what have we got? Empty lighthouse bottle. No.
Impossible. Impossible. I need something.
Do we put the empty lighthouse bottle in here?
I need something.
Now.
Impossible.
Okay. What else is there? I don't know. I can't put the...
I need something.
Right, apparently I've done it the wrong way around.
Impossible.
Oh, for fuck's sake. What I meant to do is put that... here. Turn this. And then take that and put that here.
Impossible.
For fuck's sake!
I need something.
And now, we've done it!
Bravo, Holmes!
Bravo!
No! Cast out this light! Continue the ceremony! Sing! We must sing!
Yeah, well done at keeping them at bay, Watson. They're just kind of standing there.
You will never reach the end of your song, Rochester. Take heed, as your choir is leaving. Come with me.
The choir master goes mental.
You don't understand, Holmes. He is here. He has come.
Rochester!
I called you. You came. Take me. I belong to you. The world is yours.
Oh, Jesus.
Great.
Oh, great. So we never actually get to see Cthulhu.
A singular destiny was the fate of young Lord Rochester. Those who saved him from drowning in those dark waters off the Indian coast served only to cast him into the true abyss, that of madness. A brilliant young man of noble blood, whose intelligence was perverted to the service of appalling ancient rites.
What
did he see or envision that transformed him into such a beast?
The whispering of Cthulhu. To bring
all those wretched souls to the slaughterhouse like so many sheep, then assemble a confederacy of criminals and psychopaths like the sinister Dr. Gygax, who used the sale of precious stones
like the
to
EU.
Ensure only the purest and most robust racial specimens were obtained for his purposes. Such men who would survive not only a long voyage imprisoned in the depths of a ship's hold, but the torture and drugs intended to hammer into their brains a sordid litany from the end of ages. Monster and genius, one and the same.
I didn't know Scientology was invented back then.
Next was the discreet placement of his men in cities ideally located to secure representatives of every nation on Earth. Blacks and Chinese gathered in the Americas, the people of Oceania and Asia in London,
to find Chinese
Eastern
people
and
in
Central
China.
Europeans gathered in Switzerland. Their delivery timed to the exact moment and place dictated by ancient rites and a precise stellar alignment. Finally, to find the only building perched over the water, where the builder had the convenient caprice to install Egyptian statues and then to eliminate
the lone occupant, quite convenient, really.
Taking their place by posing as their nephew and traditional heir to the post. Did genius create the evil, or evil the genius?
Anyway, I'm sure some American writer will love to write about all this stuff later on.
You are awake,
and then people
Holmes?
Will write me into the story.
Your moans got the better of my sleep, Watson.
I couldn't sleep
again.
After.
Indeed, Holmes. And this time the memories of that dreadful adventure were so vivid and real. Everything came back to me as if it were
happening
again.
Is this meant to be the end of it? Because didn't it say 2 years ago or something?
Watson, it is because you had begun to forget. The best therapy would have been for you to write on the subject, but what we saw and endured must never be revealed.
Oh, so like all the games,
we
can't write it down. We
have never even spoken on it. But do you believe that had we failed, if we had not arrived in time, if this strange ritual had seen its end?
Who knows, Watson? Who knows?
I don't give a fuck anymore.
You speak of the past. What troubles me more is the future.
Whatever do you mean?
We eliminated, or have every reason to think so, a formidable threat to our society. But by doing so, we resurrected another, a hidden danger, one laden with hate and moved by vengeance. A
ticking
bomb waiting. And a danger
yes,
wearing
topical.
A face I know far
fuck actor.
Too well.
Fuck actor, fuck soaper, fuck peeper. I think he was talking about Moriarty, actually. Woo! We finished! Ba-ba-bum-ba-ba! Alright, guys, well, thank you for sticking with me. I hope you have, at least. So, yeah, thanks a lot. And next game, probably... I'm going through all the Sherlock Holmes games, so it'll either be The Mystery of the Mummy, The Silver Earring, or Arsene Lupin. So, see you then, guys.